Continuing our discussion of dplyr, we'll now look at the concept of tidy data. Now this becomes important because many times we want to do certain kinds of analysis, but we find that the data is not in a form that is conducive to doing our analysis. Right? By not in a form, I don't mean just the level of aggregation, which you can correct through the summarize function, but in other ways. You know, things are in columns, whereas you want them to be in rows, or things are in rows, whereas you want them to be in columns. Those kinds of bigger changes to the data. So we look at the notion of tidy data, and then we learn a set of handy functions to recast the data in a form that is suitable for our analysis. So in this lesson, we'll be looking at tidy data. And the broad progress of data analysis would look something like this. So we first get our data, and then one step of the data is to tidy the data, which is just what I spoke about, which is to get the data into a form that is meaningful and useful for our analysis. And then we might transform the data, visualize it, build models, etc., and keep going through this process many times. And finally, communicate the data to the audience for whom we perform the analysis, right? So up to now, we have looked actually at data transformation, right? Which is that we take the data and summarize it in many different ways to perform our analysis, right? So we did a lot of data summarization by transforming it using the functions like filter and group by and summarize and doing those things. And then we visualized it. And that is really what we've been doing. But we might go one step further by building predictive models. And depending on how the models work, if you're not satisfied, go back and go through this process many times. And finally, when we're ready, we communicate the results, right? But before we perform even this, we might need to whip up the data to be in a good shape for us to even do these things. And that is where the tidy concept comes into play. That is, the shape of the data may not be in the form in which we want it. So that's what we'll be looking at in the next few lectures here. Okay, so the key question that comes about is, how should we represent data? Now, till now, we've always looked at data which was already in a form that was ready for the kind of analysis that we wanted to perform. So for example, if you took a look at the economics data frame, or if you took a look at the flights data frame or flights table from the NYC Flights 13 package, right? So we had all of these data sets, and the data sets were pretty much ready for analysis. You know, things were in the columns and rows as was convenient for us, okay? So for example, we can take a look at some data which looks like this. So here we've got a country, Afghanistan, and you've got Afghanistan, Brazil, China, etc. You've got the years 1999-2000 for each of the countries. So each country occurs twice. And then we've got a column called cases, right? And that is just showing you the numbers of cases. Actually, this is some kinds of tuberculosis occurrences in these countries in each of the years, and then there is the population of the country. Okay, so in 1999, Afghanistan had 745 cases of the kind of tuberculosis we are looking at. In 2000, they had 2,666, and so on for Brazil and China. And of course, this data set is large, contains data for many, many countries. Okay, so that's one way to represent this data. Now, this is not the only way in which we might find the data. Right, so it is possible that we may find the data looking like this. Right, instead of the previous set, we might have here, we've got Afghanistan 1999 cases, population. Right, so you've got a column called type, which tells you cases, population. In other words, what was on columns earlier, the cases and population were in columns. They are now sitting in the form of rows. And then you've got cases count, 745 case, population count, etc. Okay, so the information expressed in this data set is exactly the same as the information expressed in the previous one, right? However, depending on the performance or the kind of analysis we would like to do, we might prefer the data to be in this form or in the earlier form. Okay, so what we're really going to be talking about is, how do you take data that is in this format and convert it into the earlier format, namely this format? Or how do you take data which is in this format and convert it into this format, right? Because for certain analyses, we might find this to be useful. For certain other analyses, we might find that other to be useful. So we need to have an easy way to move data between these two forms. Another way to represent the data might look like this. This is extreme. So we've got date, country, year, and then we've got a column called rate, in which you've got the cases and the population expressed together. Right, so you've got 7, 4, 5, and then there's a slash, and then there's this. So this is clearly a character column in which we've got the number of cases and the population both combined with a separator. So technically, it is possible for us to pry these apart and do certain computations. But again, this represents the same information, but in a very different way. And finally, you can have even the same data spread across two tables, right? So you've got the data for 1999, 2000, the cases data, right? So for each country, you've got the cases, and the years have now gone into columns. And you've got another table which is giving you the population data for the same thing, right? So taken together, these two tables also express the data, the same data that we've been seeing till now, right? So literally what we have looked at is four different ways of representing exactly the same data. Okay, so now, which is the best way of representing the data and so on? That is somewhat of a subjective question, because the best way of representing data is basically dependent upon what kind of computations you're trying to perform. Okay, so there is this, right? So in this first data frame that we had, you've got one column per attribute or variable. So country is an attribute, year is an attribute, cases, etc. So you want to have one column per attribute. You want to have one row per observation. So assuming that this data set is about the, about each country year combination, right? That is, you want to say for this country, for this year, you've got so many cases, so much of population, right? So it depends on what you look at as central. If you looked at the year, the country and year as central to the whole analysis, right? Then in this data, we've got each row representing one entity of interest, which is Afghanistan in 1999, Afghanistan in 2000. And then you've got some other attributes that describe that central entity. So cases and population. So in that sense, we've got one row per observation, right? Where each observation stands for an entity of interest. And in this case, the entity of interest is the country year combination. Now, in a different context, you may have your entity of interest as just the country, in which case the data would be represented differently. Okay. And of course, you have one cell per value, right? That is, each cell contains just one value. Multiple values are not jammed together in the cell. Okay, and that is a requirement of what is sometimes called in databases as a requirement for data in every cell to be atomic. That is, you cannot further break it down from the point of view of the application. Okay, so that's the basic idea that we want to have. We want to have one column per attribute. We want to have one row per observation, and we want to have only one value in each cell. We don't want to jam multiple values into an individual cell, right? Of course, all of this is determined by what is your notion of what is the data representing, meaning the data is rows about what, okay? And that is somewhat subjective, okay? So that is what we are talking about here. We have the notion of tidy data, where every column represents a variable, every row represents an observation, and each cell represents a single value.